Hey guys, this week we're talking about the five things you must know about breathing and bracing when it comes to the Olympic lifts. Now this question comes from a follower on Instagram, and it's part of our series that we're doing. We're answering a question a bit deeper than just a text response once a week. So if you have a question, hit us up on Instagram and ask it. And if this video helps you, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to get more of these questions each week. So let's get into it.
All right, the first must know about breathing and bracing is, what is breathing and bracing? If we're not sure what it is, it's difficult to apply it to the lift, let alone do it well. So we know what breathing is, and I would simplify bracing as activating the abdominal wall. Now, when we combine them together well, we essentially create a core that attaches our legs to our upper body and allows us to apply much more force into an object while maintaining control of our joints. So put very simply, so by doing this well, you're able to put more force into the bar, lift more, and have control of your joints. Okay, so why is it important? Why is breathing and bracing and doing it well important? Now, number one, why are you doing the Olympic lifts? I imagine you would like to perform your best. I imagine you would like to lift the most that you can. Well, when we do it well, we can apply more force into the bar and lift much more weight. It also enables us to lower the risk of injury because we have control of our joint. So now any injury risk has been lowered, our performance has been increased. That is the true value of breathing and bracing well in Olympic lift, and that's why it's important. So to apply breathing and bracing well to an Olympic lift, let's talk about how to get set up, how to use it with a lift. And it all starts when you're standing over the bar. In this position, you want to allow yourself to get your ribs and pelvis in line and take what we call a pre-breath. And this pre-breath adds some intra-abdominal pressure to your system, and your abdominal wall starts to activate to retain that pressure. Now, with that pre-breath, we can then sit to the bar and start to get set. When we sit to the bar, we keep that pre-breath in there. Now, we can inhale more and we can exhale a little bit, but we don't want to let ourselves completely relax and exhale that pressure that we just created from the pre-breath. We want to sit down to the bar, and we want to get set, and then as we get set and we're ready to come off the ground, we can add more pressure. Go ahead and at this time, breathe in more, pressurizing that core even more, and now you're set to come off the floor well. If we sit down to the bar without taking that pre-breath, what happens is our ribs and pelvis get out of line. And when our ribs and pelvis get out of line, it minimizes how well we can activate the abdominal wall 360 degrees around. Now, breathing and bracing can go a whole lot deeper into this. So, you know, keep that in mind. If you're unsure about what you're doing with your breathing and brace, the best thing you can do is to get a coach, and they can guide you, they can teach you. Another option is to continue to learn. So breathing and bracing well when we apply it to the Olympic lifts, gonna have some big payoffs. And this is exactly how we do it when we step up to the bar. So how do we know when we breathe and brace incorrectly? So must know number four is signs of the brace and the breathing failing. And a lot of signs can show. So getting tugged off the floor, falling out of position off the floor when you're starting to push with your legs can be a sign that you weren't braced well to come off the floor. Receiving the bar and collapsing when we kind of collapse and round over in our upper back and start to break trying to receive the bar, that is a sign of breathing and bracing not going well. Foot movement at inappropriate times during the lift, if we're pushing through the floor, then as we pass our knees, our feet move a little bit. That moment in time right there shows we're no longer pushing into the floor. And very often the muscles in our back have turned on and we started to take the bar with our back, and that is a sign of a brace breaking down. So there's a lot of signs out there. If you're struggling with pain in your lower back and your hip and your shoulders, these are all signs that could be coming back to how we're breathing and bracing when it comes to the lift. So must know number five is, how can you get better at breathing and bracing for the Olympic lifts? And I said this earlier in one of the earlier steps, that you can get a coach and they can guide you through. So that's the one where if you want the results the fastest, there you go. You have other options as well. You can continue to learn about them. And if that's your interest, some great organizations out there are DNS, Dynamic Neuromuscular Stability. They have some great resources, and there's great individuals out there as well, such as Dr. Richard Ohm of Athlete Enhancement. He's helped us a ton. So there's a great amount of resources out there that you can continue to learn with this. I really prefer getting a coach. You're going to get the results the quickest. You're going to get learning and lessons directed to you. Invest in yourself and invest in your lifts, and you can move well. You can move with less pain and maximize while you're in the gym in the first place. So those are some options to get better at it, and getting better at it is vital.
Hey guys, if you found this helpful and you're looking to get stronger in the Olympic lifts and ready to kick any nagging pain you might have out of training, then check out this 12-week program. You're gonna be excited when you find out more details about it. We look forward to getting to chat with you.